Okay, I've been a bit tricky in the last couple of exercises because when I organized all of the chromosomes from biggest to smallest, I left out a pair. I left out the very last pair because, as you notice, there's something very unique about them. They don't match in size in the pair the way all the other chromosomes do. In fact, they're so different and they're important for a very different reason that they're not numbered like the other chromosomes. It's the 23rd pair, but each chromosome, because it's unique from the other, has its own name. We call the bigger chromosome the X chromosome and the smaller chromosome the Y chromosome. Together, we call these chromosomes the sex chromosomes. All of the rest of the chromosomes are called autosomes. And the reason we make a distinction is because the sex chromosomes, X and Y, determine the sex of the individual. What we mean by sex is whether or not the individual has male reproductive organs or female reproductive organs. And there's a very interesting story as to why the Y chromosome is so much smaller than the X chromosome and they don't match. The story is awesomely amazing, but it's really outside the scope of our course. So if you're interested, you should go search for more about it on your own. The key point here is that the Y chromosome triggers male development. So if you have a Y chromosome, you're most likely going to develop as a male. Without a Y chromosome, ultimately the individual will develop as a female. Now I want you to tell me, using this set of chromosomes that you see right here, if this was an individual's genome, what sex would most likely develop from this set of chromosomes? Would you expect to get a male or a female?